Do not attempt the training techniques you are about to see without consulting a professional. Tonight on Caesar 911.
She's taking off, grab her.
A dog that runs away.
Ivy!
Whenever it gets scared.
The day we got her, Ivy ran away twice.
And panics easily, especially at loud noises.
Ivy!
Freeing herself from any restraint and able to jump over any fence.
When Ivy escapes, she's gone.
Breaking her owner's heart.
I feel like Ivy does love me, but when she hops that fence, it's all gone.
And trapping the whole family.
Our life is totally being controlled by this dog.
The other way.
Can Caesar save this dog?
Oh my God.
Hey!
Before something worse happens.
She'll take off right in the middle of the street. If a car comes, boom.
Ivy!
This is Caesar 911. Caesar is called by a frustrated couple concerned about their daughter's runaway dog.
I got a call from a family. They're in desperate hell. They're at the end of the road with the dog. And this dog is escaping. They don't know what to do. It's not aggressive. It's just escaping. Let's find out what's really happening in this family. All right.
Hi, Caesar. Welcome.
Eleanor?
Eleanor,
nice to meet
yes.
you.
Craig?
Mr. Craig? Nice to meet you, sir.
Come on over.
All right.
Sit down with us.
So what's the problem?
Our daughter, Wendy,
yeah.
has a dog named Ivy.
Mm-hmm.
Ivy is an escape artist who will jump over fences anytime she hears a loud noise. When she jumps a fence, she's gone. Ivy is like Houdini. She disappears. Pew. I'm in total fear that she's going to hurt herself. She'll take off right in the middle of the street. If a car comes, boom.
She panics.
Completely panics. Yeah. I mean, she shakes everything.
So what are some of the sounds that make Ivy scared, afraid, or anxious?
Well, I would say the air compressor mm-hmm. is the biggest. Pretty much any power tool. I'm a general contractor. And I'm constantly working around the house.
We put the dog in the house. We turn on the radio really loud, put the dog in Wendy's bedroom, shut the door, the radio's going, and he can use the compressor.
Yeah.
Wow.
He has given up jobs. And giving up jobs
meaning
losing money.
Yeah. When it runs away sometimes, I feel like hopefully someone finds it and takes it away.
Right.
It would be great for me, you know.
You're mean.
It would. That's it. You know, I just fed up with it, you know.
So what about Wendy? What has she tried?
Wendy's at her wit's end, too. She'll do anything for her. She'll take her for walks, but it's Ivy walking Wendy and not Wendy walking Ivy. Wendy also bought her a harness. So we thought maybe that would help her, that she can get out of a harness.
Yeah.
Houdini. We've tried to crate her. She's broken out of them. We'll find her in the house, quivering in a corner somewhere.
Yeah.
We're just shocked that a dog that little can tear out of a crate.
Well, fear is very strong.
I'm almost positive Ivy was abused. She was returned to the shelter twice. She has two BBs in her chest.
Like BB, like somebody shot her?
Yeah.
So maybe that's the sound of the gun.
She relates to pain.
She relates.
So you think over time, she would have just figured it out.
No, hey.
But she's still in the past.
She's stuck there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where's her fast forward button?
She's taking off. You need to grab her.
Our life is totally being controlled by this dog. That's the part that upsets me the most, because we can't go anywhere. We can't be a family with this dog. I want my family back.
Yeah.
And I want the dog to be part of my family.
So what's the best way for me to see this behavior from Ivy?
I could just turn on any power tool and she'll just bolt.
You want to see it?
Let's go.
Okay.
Looking forward. I'm actually super intrigued how intense this dog wants to escape from the house. It's been 6 years. It's a long time. I can see that they don't know how to help the dog to move forward. Let's go and see it.
With Ivy and Wendy in back, Craig and Eleanor ask Caesar to watch in the front yard as Craig turns on the compressor.
All right, Mr. Craig, turn it on.
Some of Caesar's crew members are able to catch Ivy before she can run any farther away.
Ivy! It's okay!
When I chase Ivy, my heart is just racing. And out of the corner of my eye, I see Caesar Milan. But I'm not thinking about saying hello.
Go get her. Go get her.
I'm thinking about getting Ivy. Come on, Ivy.
Hi, Wendy.
Hello.
My name is Wendy, and I have a 6-year-old rescue dog named Ivy, who has escaped over 100 times, and my parents are done. We decided to get Ivy because my home wasn't complete without a dog, so my mom and I went to our local shelter, and my mom was like, oh, this one looks cute and it's quiet. And it so happened to be Ivy. But the day we got her, Ivy ran away twice. We're driving home from the shelter and we decided to stop and get food. And Ivy just took off. And then when we got home, we decided to take her on a walk and she got out of her collar and Ivy was gone in the middle of the intersection by my house. I discovered that this is a pattern with her. She is an escape artist. When Ivy first escaped from our house, we didn't know how she did it. But later we found out it was the fence that she was jumping. The evidence was blood on the fence from her jumping it. Ivy has hurt herself plenty of times from running away. When she hears any loud noise, especially power tools, she's gone.
Hey, hey!
And my worst fear when Ivy gets out is that she might get run over. Because she runs in the middle of intersections, and I don't want to pick up a dead Ivy in the street. My family's very strained from Ivy because we have to basically make our house like a prison to keep her in. And my parents want to get rid of her, but because of me, she is around, and it's not like I can move out because I'm a college student. I'm broke. So I will do anything to convince them that she needs to stay in this household. I feel like I'm her only hope, and I want to take on that challenge because she's my dog. So I don't know what Caesar can do, but I hope he can help because I would be devastated without her. I get asked all the time why I love Ivy. And my answer is, I just do. I can't describe love to Ivy because how can you describe love to anybody else? It's just there. I love coming home and she's there. I love laying on my bed and she's there and cuddling with me. I feel like Ivy does love me, but when she hops that fence, it's all gone. She forgets who I am. But she is my dog. She's like my child. I love her. That's it.
So, you want to learn how to walk?
Sure.
Yeah, like, yeah. So, can you see the tension there? Can you feel your tension?
Yeah.
So, let's go back to where you got her. Before I do anything else, I have to show Wendy how to walk her dog because she has no idea how to do that. That's one of the most basic and important ways to establish yourself as a confident leader to your dog. Do you want to try?
Okay.
Yeah, relax. Yeah. All right. Don't look at the dog, just feel it through the leash. Yeah. So the more you do this, the more the dog is gonna do that. The more you learn to do this, the more you slow the brain down. You see the difference?
So bring my arm up here?
Yeah, so this is more like you putting your gas pedal in the car.
Yeah.
So if you do this, the car is gonna go.
Yeah.
But if you do this, this is your brakes.
Okay.
So right now what you're doing is slow down, therefore you use your brakes.
Okay.
So you wanna be the source of calm, being calm, relaxed, peace, trust.
Okay.
See, it's foreign to you.
Yeah.
You look tense.
I just don't want her. I feel like she's gonna run.
Okay, so let me change. Watch the difference. See, look at this little thing. So I'm not worried about her running away. I'm using calmness as a way of communication. Therefore, I stop her from pulling.
Mm-hmm. I never knew I was walking Ivy Ron. So that was a big eye opener. It's like, oh, I need to relax.
Teaching her how not to be afraid of sound is one thing, but teaching you guys not to worry is the most challenging thing.
Yeah.
She's been escaping for 6 years, but you also guys been worrying for 6 years.
Yeah.
So both of you guys have a bad habit.
Yeah.
As Caesar and Wendy return to her home, Caesar asks her father, Craig, to turn on the air compressor.
Don't think about what's going to happen. We're setting it up.
Okay.
Where you're going to see the reaction and how I react to the situation. Mr. Craig, can you turn it on?
Yeah.
This way. Do you want to try it?
Caesar is working with Wendy and her dog Ivy, a rescue with a history of abuse that includes being shot with a BB gun. Now, Ivy runs away every time she hears a loud noise. One of her biggest triggers...
Can you turn it on?
...is Wendy's dad's air compressor.
The whole reaction is momentarily, and then it goes away. Because then they realize that they can't fight.
Okay.
It allows her to see running away is not an option. So what's my other option? Ignore.
Yeah.
But if you go, oh my God, and then you actually charge her.
Freaking out because they have the nail gun going and
a war zone. That's right. But on top of that, you feel worse than her.
Yeah.
So she doesn't feel safe.
Okay.
You worrying with her.
It's not helping.
It's not helping, yeah. You worry, she worries. You become afraid of her running away, she becomes afraid of the compressor.
Yeah. I did not realize my mood was affecting Ivy as much as it has. I thought this was just all Ivy and not me. I'm just afraid she's just gonna take off. She thrashes and she'll...
Yeah, yeah.
She knows how to get out of it.
Yeah, because that's all you've seen. So your truth is escape, escape, escape. That's like a billboard escaping.
That's been my life since we've gotten her.
6 years?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's been very stressful.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. It's amazing what fear can do to people and to their dogs. In this case, when Wendy is with Ivy, she's constantly afraid she's about to escape, and Ivy feeds off that. So I also need to see how Craig and Eleanor act around Ivy. And your mom says she's very friendly to dogs.
Yeah, but we don't put her around dogs because my mom kind of freaks out.
What?
Yeah.
How come?
She's witnessed a big dog fight, and she can't go near two dogs anymore. Oh,
but it wasn't her.
No. We didn't have her yet.
Oh, something that she experienced.
Yeah, she experienced.
Oh, my goodness. You guys are full of fear.
You threw me under the bus.
No, she didn't throw you. I mean, that's very important because I'm going to put her around dogs.
It's brutal.
They shredded that dog.
Yeah.
Ever since then, I can't walk with her.
Around other dogs.
Around other dogs, I go the other direction.
Yes.
And if there's another dog coming, we cross the street.
Yeah.
It's hard.
Because you have so much fear. You know what I mean? Fear escaping, fear of her getting hurt. There's a lot of fear going on here.
Yeah.
Yes.
After seeing that event, my whole life changed. When I walk and we see another dog, I flip out. I break out into a cold sweat, and I am terrified that this is going to happen to Ivy.
She can actually learn that dogs are negative if you hold a leash. Because every time you see it, you do this, you run the other way. So, right? So it's like the air compressor. You have three problems. You have excitement, you have anxiety, and then you have fear.
Yeah.
Now I'm beginning to see the whole picture. It's not just Wendy that is affecting Ivy. It's the whole family, and they are paralyzed by fear, actually trapped by the dog that they rescued. How are you feeling, Mr. Craig?
It's all good, but...
Yeah, I gotta prove it to you.
I wanna have a lot of hope, but... I don't have a lot of confidence just because we've gone through so much over the last 6 years. So I don't expect a lot.
Once you see her, you become a believer. Right now, you can't even see it. For Wendy and her mom, my challenge is overcoming their fears. But Mr. Craig is another story. He's just about giving up on Ivy. But I need to get him on board because it's going to take the whole family to fix this problem.
I trust you, so.
Thank you. That's all it is. The first thing I need to do is to take Ivy out of this environment because it has been nothing but fear for the past 6 years. And try to control her reaction to loud noises in a calm, safe place. I'm going to take her. Is that okay with you?
Okay.
Thank you. You're going to give us our family back?
I think it's time for us to start.
Okay, that sounds great.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
All right.
Thank you. You all right, Wendy?
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you.
Keep your posted.
Okay, bye-bye.
She's not saying no.
I'm emotional because I'm going to miss her, but I have to push my emotions aside because I know when she comes back and with Caesar's help, it will be a lot better.
All right, so it's very important to take a dog like this, not because she's pretty anxious and fearful and excited, because all the stories the family have. That, to me, is a bigger concern right now. So I'm going to give them a break, to both of them. Yeah. All right. Let's go.
The next day, Caesar brings Ivy to his dog psychology center.
So today I'm really excited for Ivy because I'm about to introduce her to the treadmill. Then I'm going to turn on the air compressor. What I'm hoping for her is just to feel comfortable and relaxed right next to the sound. And the goal is to desensitize Ivy to the sounds that have made her panic in the past. So I'm going to put her in the treadmill. And then Mercer is going to turn on the air compressor. All right. What I want is for her to pay attention to something else. This is redirecting. Very good. Good girl, Ivy. Good girl. Good girl. That's a good girl. Turn it on.
Caesar takes Ivy to the dog psychology center to desensitize her to the loud sounds that trigger her panic state.
Turn it on.
But when he puts Ivy on the treadmill, Caesar faces his first challenge.
She relaxed, we will stop the air compressor. That's how she learns how the air compressor does. She relaxed. Nice, nice. Very good, very good. This is good. It's working. There you go, there you go. Took her to the panic state, but not leave her there. See, she's learning that if she goes in the middle, calms down, surrender, things stop. Come on. This was a good first step. Ivy made some progress, but she's been living in a fearful state for the past 6 years. We're not going to correct the problem overnight. Tomorrow will be even more important because I want to build on the small progress we made today.
The next day, Caesar continues looking for ways to control Ivy's anxieties.
All right, guys, we're going to go back into the dog park and introduce the air compressor. What I'm trying to find out is what strategy works the best. Is it starting Ivy on the treadmill, then turning on the air compressor, or turning on the air compressor and then getting her on the treadmill? I'm coming out with everything that I can think of so I can find out what works for Ivy. Turn it on. Go ahead. Right now, Ivy is reacting the same way she does at home. Whenever Mr. Craig turns on the air compressor, she jumps the fence. But her family has never properly corrected this behavior. First thing is to let her know that jumping over the fence is not what we want. This is better. See, now, instead of her focusing on the gate, she's redirecting, there you go. She's coming back to us, which that's exactly what we want. The touch is just so the brain doesn't keep focusing on the flight. Focus on something else, and that's when she starts focusing on me. This time I started with the compressor, and Ivy immediately got excited and looked for an escape, just like she does at home. Turn it on. Now I'm gonna put her back on the treadmill while it's moving, so she will hopefully focus on walking instead of the compressor.
better? That's good. So what's good about it that she's giving me eye contact? Like, help me. Yes, I want her to look for help. I want her to look for human for help. And we just let her relax. Getting Ivy to walk on the treadmill was really good because it kept her brain busy and allowed her to enter a calm state. Then when she looked up at me, she got to see a strong, confident human looking back at her, which is something she needs, but she never experienced that back at home. She's doing better, but I don't like how her energy shifted when she got off of the treadmill. She's still in that flight state. Uh-oh, she's starting to panic. Shh. Hey!
Caesar has made progress getting Ivy to walk calmly on the treadmill, right next to a loud air compressor.
That's good.
But when the exercise ends, a setback.
The other way, the other way, the other way. Yeah, she's not going too far. Ivy is a tough case, and one of the most interesting I ever faced. Getting shot in the chest with a BB gun has really done damage. We're talking about over 6 years of living with fear. So it's gonna take a lot of work and repetition to get her over her need of running away. No. No. So right now, I'm blocking with sound her need or her want to run away. Shh. Hey. Hey. Go. Hey. Let's go. So even though she ran away through that fence, and as you see, her mind wants to go back. Shh. Hey. Hey. Let's go. Success is every day you try. It is not successful when you don't even try. So, do I learn what I need to do? Of course. That she's still jumping? Of course. But I'm still learning about 6 years of a dog escaping. So if I go and correct the dog a few times and touch, and the dog goes on the ground and surrender, and it goes right back and do it, it doesn't mean that the first time it failed. It means that repetitions is going to let her know the fear is not what I want. It's for her to become calm and surrender to follow my lead. There you go. It took a while for us to get to this frame of mind. And right now, few times later, made her feel that that was not a good choice. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Hey.
over the next several days.
All right, turn it on.
Caesar continues his one-on-one training with Ivy.
Ivy! Every time she touches a wall, I'm gonna bring it back. There you go. Turn it off, turn it off. There you go. Come on, guys.
Using different exercises to desensitize her to loud sounds.
Ivy, ready. Let's go. Really good. She looks like the rest of the pack. The tail is in the middle. The ears are slightly behind. She feels she has a goal. She has a job. She belongs to something bigger. On top of that, the sound of the diesel is related to that frame of mind. That is a mind-blowing rehabilitation. This is what I love.
Finally, Caesar decides it's time to take Ivy out into the real world to experience the kinds of sounds that have triggered her in the past.
Okay, I'm in my house. This is in my neighborhood. This is the time where all the gardeners come. There's some construction going on and 2 blocks away from my house. So we're going to go and introduce Ivy. We're definitely making big progress in fear. And right now we're just going after the anxiety. This is war zone for her. All these big machines happening here. This big loud sound over here. I don't know what it is. All these big constructions here. All these cars. Hear that sound over there. This is real. All right, turn it on.
Caesar has spent 2 weeks rehabilitating Ivy, one of his most challenging cases yet.
Really good.
Now, continuing his goal of desensitizing her to loud sounds, Caesar challenges Ivy to walk through a construction zone.
All these big constructions here, all these cars, hear that sound over there. This is real. We're going this way. This is good. We just passed by a big truck. She just did it like a champ. So good. Look at that. Good girl. That's a good girl.
After a successful walk through the construction site,
go inside, Mercer.
Caesar returns home for his most crucial test. He wants Ivy to face down her biggest trigger, the air compressor.
Mercer is going to turn on the air compressor, and her job is to go back into the garage. Remember, she would normally run out of the house, so I'm teaching her that she can go towards the air compressor. I'm pushing her because I know she can do it. Good girl, good girl. That's a good girl. That's that little switch, that little... See how she slowed down? Let's go. Good girl. As soon as we walk in, we're gonna turn it off. Good girl. Good girl. That's a good girl. Good girl. Good girl. That's a good. Hey. So we're stopping the flight. She can run away. Her job is to settle down, take it to a different frame of mind. More of that. No shaking, no fear. So my goal is to help the brain move forward, backwards, now move, surrender. Good girl, good girl. Look. That's how we end the exercise.
The next day.
Welcome to our house.
Caesar and his girlfriend Jahira invite Wendy and her family to their house.
Ivy's come a long way toward conquering her fear, and I always knew it was possible. But convincing the family is another story.
Come on in, come on in.
The last time they saw Ivy,
Their dog was running all over the place every time she heard a loud sound. Driving everyone crazy. So I'm really excited to show everyone how Ivy can behave when surrounded by calm energy.
So this is the plan. I want to bring Wendy to where the dogs are. I'm going to blindfold you because I don't want you to see her. For you, it's just going to be sound of the air compressor and then feeling. I want you to get in touch with how it feels when a dog comes to you while the sound is there. Because your expectations are sound, she's away from me. So we're going to change that. It's sound, she comes near you.
I just don't believe it. I need to see it.
That's what we say. So we're going to go first feeling and then seeing.
Okay.
And what I want you guys to do is to watch it from here. We're going to put a, baby, you put the blindfolding. Yeah. This family love Ivy, but does not believe that Ivy can get better. So I have to change that perception. I have to make them a believers. I have to show them that Ivy can live without fear. Okay, come on. She doesn't know you're coming.
It's a little step, step. Mm-hmm. That's it, one.
That's Ivy. Look, she's wagging her tail. Yeah. She sees Wendy.
So on your right is a pug. On your left is her. Yeah. Come over here so you can sit down right. Turn around, baby. Come on. Come on. Sit down. There you go. Nice, nice. Very good. That's your girl.
She's right.
Now we're going to turn on the air compressor, okay?
Yeah.
So that's the shaking, we got the flight. So we're removing the run, but the shaking is, that's anxiety, that's not fear anymore. There you go.
Look, yeah. She's sitting right next to Wendy.
Turn it on. And then she came back.
Oh my God. Caesar turned the compressor on and Ivy just sat there. We're like, wait, is this a trick camera? I mean, what's going on? We don't understand this. She sat.
She's not running away.
Uh-oh.
Well, that's good, I guess. Yeah, to me, it looks like she's still nervous, but she's accepting that and just pushing through it.
So what you're saying is my voice, my wishes, my desires are stronger than the fear that that thing causes.
Yeah, before she would try to run and look for a way out.
Now we're going to open the garage. Yes, I know.
Same, what do you think?
That's a good girl.
I was shocked to see the change in Ivy. She was calm when the compressor was on, and that was mind-boggling.
Caesar wants Wendy to experience taking Ivy near loud noises without him, so he has Jahira lead them past a construction vehicle near his house.
They'll let him pass you. Letting Jahira lead the path and give her the confidence to Wendy so we can start sending Wendy into a mission.
Doing good.
This is amazing.
You really have to see this more like a mission of how to rehabilitate a dog. Therefore, that's how you rescue a dog.
If you hesitate, she's gonna hesitate.
Yeah.
So just be calm. Like, this is normal. It's just this car there. Like, it's cute.
Yeah. We got this. She's in it.
High five, right?
Yeah.
How did it go?
Ivy did amazing. She started to hesitate for a moment, so then she was like...
So she pulled me.
So I was like, no, you're fine. Don't hesitate. It's just a cute car.
Okay.
Yeah. Walking past the construction zone, Ivy was hesitant, So that made me hesitant, but then Jahira knew to push me, and that's when the confidence kicked in. But I saw firsthand that if she's hesitant, I can't be hesitant. So that was my challenge, and I need to work on that now.
Unbelievable.
I'm amazed. I really am.
Good.
I'm amazed.
So now that you see that it's possible, when she goes back home, there is a memory that we have to erase.
Yeah.
But that memory can be erased quicker if we, the humans, are calm and assertive.
Okay.
I have to help this family to develop calm, assertive energy as a unit.
So tomorrow I'm going to bring Ivy back home and surprise them with an assignment to address their fear.
Thank you, Wendy. Appreciate it. Did you enjoy yourself today? Hopefully the exercise we're about to do with them can really help them help each other. Because they have to, they're going to need each other. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
The next day, Caesar brings Ivy home to Wendy and her family to explain the exercise he has in mind for them.
So today is a big day. Now the ball is on the owner's hands. We got to send them to a place where they have to face their fear.
Exciting day.
Yes. Good.
Look, everybody's here. How are you?
Good.
How are you? Good. How are you? There you go. How are you? There you go. There you go.
Oh my gosh.
Good?
Yes, good.
Yeah, give a lot. You can totally do a lot of excitement here.
This is great.
Ivy's make great progress, but this journey won't be complete unless the family overcomes their fears. It's very important to switch fear to relaxation at least. You know, so if you don't have that with her, you can do it with something else. So we set up an activity for you guys to work together. You guys are going to handle snakes and spiders.
Oh, no.
Come on, you can do it. You can do it.
Yay.
It's going to be everything nice and easy. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Sometimes you need to try something different. So to get this family past their fear, what better way than to face a classic phobia dead on? Creepy crawlers. So I arranged for them to meet with my friend Marco, a reptile handler.
Hello, guys.
Hi there.
Welcome to their snake house.
When I first walked in, I heard the rattlesnakes immediately, and I was not having it. I'm thinking no.
Now, you just wait there, and I have something for you. Look at this one.
Relax.
Caesar has been working with Wendy and her family on conquering their own fears, which have made Ivy, their dog, panic-stricken for the last 6 years. As a final exercise, Caesar sends the family to a snake and spider wrangler.
Now, you just wait there and I have something for you.
When Marco first brought out the snake, I was petrified.
Okay, I'm like wigging out here.
That thing is huge.
So Caesar asked us to bring you here to give it a try with snakes, which you already say no, and that is no good. Caesar wants me to teach the family to face their fears. We're going to start with the little ones. Go like that. It's okay. Today we're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to work with snakes, tarantulas, reptiles and bugs. How about if we try the scorpion? You want to hold it?
No.
I was scared. I honestly wanted to leave.
I do not want to hold a scorpion. I don't think anybody would want to.
No. See, if you panic, you're going to chuck him and you're going to hurt him.
Okay, can you get off now?
But you need to relax first. It's all about relaxing. That's what you need to take home. You need to learn that. Otherwise, you panic. You transmit that to the animal, and then he's going to nail you hard. Be scared is no bad, but you need to control it. It's fine.
I'm relaxed.
See?
Take, yeah. As Marco was talking to me, he told me to breathe, and that's when I started to calm down.
There you go.
At that moment, I did feel like I was letting go of fear, so I was okay after a while.
There you go. His name is Banana.
I thought I was terrified of spiders and snakes.
How you feel? You good? Oh. What we learned today? We've been here for half an hour or more.
Relax.
Just relax.
There was no thought in my mind that I was going to hold a snake as big as Banana.
How you feeling?
Good. But good? I have to challenge my fear. Take a breath. Relax.
You taking a good thing from here, I hope.
Which yes. Is, no fear.
No fear. You know, you're going to transmit that energy, good energy to your dog.
My whole attitude's changed. I can see myself now walking Ivy with no fear. I think I'm going to do fine.
Come back all anytime, right. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Bye-bye.
All right.
Bye-bye. Bye. Wow.
The next day, Caesar returns to Wendy's home for one last visit.
It's been a week since I left Ivy here. I asked the owners to do something together, something that is extremely daring, challenging. It's really about being together and supporting each other. So I am excited to see how they did.
Hello.
How are you?
How you doing?
Good, good, good. How are you? Oh, you can let it go. You can let it go. Yes, yes, oh, yes, yeah. Yes. We miss you too.
Aww.
Yes. There you go, back home.
See?
So her loyalty is right there.
Oh, good girl.
So, 1 week later.
I want to tell him about the snake.
Did you actually touch it?
I did.
So what's the feeling?
I'm amazed that I was able to hold a snake. And I was really excited because Marco gave me the skin off of one of the snakes. And I'm an elementary school teacher. So I brought it back to the classroom and kids were like, and I said, no, you can't act like that. You have to channel your fear. And I'm like, wait a minute.
So you paid it forward. You paid it forward. That's awesome.
So it was awesome. Yeah.
At the end of the day is the similarity of how you deal with animals.
Yeah.
Regardless of the species. So calm energy is actually the source of how to deal with snakes or spiders or dogs.
Yeah.
But if you face your fears with anything, it's going to transfer into other areas of your life.
That's what I'm hoping for.
Yeah, that's why I wanted you guys to do it together.
Exactly.
I think the family is finally starting to realize there is nothing to be afraid of. Ivy is a great dog. And she's come such a long way. So if they have no fear, then she'll have no fear.
I'm able to walk her without a leash and I'm not, like, afraid. I trust her and she stays by me. It's pretty cool.
She's definitely a heck of a lot better.
Oh, my gosh. Amazing.
I mean, it's like night and day. She goes right to the noise and she sits down or lays down.
The opposite of running away.
Exactly.
That's right. So that's good.
That is not good. That is really good. And it's only going to get better. Can we go for a little walk?
Yeah.
All right.
Sure.
Great.
Now I want to see this confidence in action so I can make sure they're really maintaining this calm energy. And the ultimate test will be Mr. Craig's air compressor. All right, turn on the air compressor.
She does it.
Lower the hand. There you go. Nice. Beauty.
It's good.
Nice. That's exactly what I wanted to see. Wendy and her family have made so much progress. You can see their confidence has grown, and that gives Ivy the confidence she needs. She's calm, happy, and staying right where she belongs, next to her family. Well, thank you very much
All right.
for testing me.
That's the hardest thing.
It's been a long journey, but I feel like this family gained confidence, and that will be passed on to Ivy, which I never thought would be possible.
Thank you for everything that you've shared with us. We have all conquered our own individual fears, and it's going to be a fearless environment.
Big help.
We're so appreciative.
I really believe that Caesar could do miracles after seeing what he's done with our dog, and I'm so happy.
Yay.
You know.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
Ivy, we see you home, all right? One day.
Bye.
Bye, guys. For me, this is very meaningful because every time I help a dog, it makes me feel really good. But when I help a dog that is so broken, that has for many, many years, 6 years, been afraid of living in her own home with her family that's already thrown the towel and they're just living in fear, I'm glad that we gave them the freedom back. I'm glad that they understand the steps. And I'm glad that they're doing this together as a family, finally.
Do not attempt the training techniques you are about to see without consulting a professional. Tonight on Caesar 911.
She's taking off, grab her.
A dog that runs away.
Ivy!
Whenever it gets scared.
The day we got her, Ivy ran away twice.
And panics easily, especially at loud noises.
Ivy!
Freeing herself from any restraint. And able to jump over any fence.
When Ivy escapes, she's gone.
Breaking her owner's heart.
I feel like Ivy does love me, but when she hops that fence, it's all gone.
And trapping the whole family.
Our life is totally being controlled by this dog.
The other way.
Can Caesar save this dog?
Oh my God.
Hey.
Before something worse happens.
She'll take off right in the middle of the street. If a car comes, boom.
Ivy!
This is Caesar 911. Caesar is called by a frustrated couple. Concerned about their daughter's runaway dog.
I got a call from a family. They're in desperate hell. They're at the end of the road with the dog. And this dog is escaping. They don't know what to do. It's not aggressive. It's just escaping. Let's find out what's really happening in this family.
All right.
Hi, Caesar. Welcome.
Eleanor?
Eleanor,
nice to meet
yes.
you.
Craig?
Mr. Craig? Nice to meet you, sir.
Come on over.
All right.
And sit down with us.
So what's the problem?
Our daughter, Wendy,
yeah.
has a dog named Ivy.
Mm-hmm.
Ivy is an escape artist who will jump over fences anytime she hears a loud noise. Once she jumps the fence, she's gone. Ivy is like Houdini. She disappears. Pew. I'm in total fear that she's going to hurt herself. She'll take off right in the middle of the street. If a car comes, boom.
She panics.
Completely panics. Yeah. I mean, she shakes, everything.
So what are some of the sounds that make Ivy scared, afraid, or anxious?
I would say the air compressor is the biggest. Pretty much any power tool. I'm a general contractor. And I'm constantly working around the house.
We put the dog in the house. We turn on the radio really loud, put the dog in Wendy's bedroom, shut the door, the radio's going, and he can use the compressor.
Yeah.
Wow.
He has given up jobs. And giving up jobs
meaning
losing money.
Yeah. When it runs away sometimes, I feel like hopefully someone finds it and takes it away.
Right.
It would be great for me, you know.
You're mean.
It would. That's it. You know, I just fed up with it, you know.
So what about Wendy? What has she tried?
Wendy's at her wit's end, too. She'll do anything for her. She'll take her for walks, but it's Ivy walking
Wendy and not Wendy walking Ivy. Wendy also bought her a harness. So we thought maybe that would help her, that she can get out of a harness.
Yeah.
Houdini. We've tried to crate her. She's broken out of them. We'll find her in the house, quivering in a corner somewhere. Yeah. We're just shocked that a dog that little can tear out of a crate.
Well, fear is very strong.
I'm almost positive Ivy was abused. She was returned to the shelter twice. She has two BBs in her chest.
Like BB, like somebody shot her?
Yeah.
So maybe that's the sound of the gun.
She relates to pain.
She relates.
So you think over time, she would have just figured it out.
No, hey,
but she's still in the past.
She's stuck there.
Yeah. Yeah.
Where's her fast forward button?
She's taking off. You need to grab her.
Our life is totally being controlled by this dog. That's the part that upsets me the most, because we can't go anywhere. We can't be a family with this dog. I want my family back.
Yeah.
And I want the dog to be part of my family.
So what's the best way for me to see this behavior from Ivy?
I could just turn on any power tool and she'll just bolt.
You want to see it?
Let's go.
Okay.
Looking forward. I'm actually super intrigued how intense this dog wants to escape from the house. It's been 6 years, it's a long time. I can see that they don't know how to help the dog to move forward. Let's go and see it.
With Ivy and Wendy in back, Craig and Eleanor ask Caesar to watch in the front yard as Craig turns on the compressor.
All right, Mr. Craig, turn it on.
Some of Caesar's crew members are able to catch Ivy before she can run any farther away.
Ivy! It's okay!
When I chase Ivy, my heart is just racing. And out of the corner of my eye, I see Caesar Milan. But I'm not thinking about saying hello.
Go get her. Go get her.
I'm thinking about getting Ivy. Come on, Ivy.
Hi, Wendy.
Hello. My name is Wendy, and I have a 6-year-old rescue dog named Ivy, who has escaped over 100 times, and my parents are done. We decided to get Ivy because my home wasn't complete without a dog, so my mom and I went to our local shelter, and my mom was like, oh, this one looks cute and it's quiet. And it so happened to be Ivy. But the day we got her, Ivy ran away twice. We're driving home from the shelter and we decided to stop and get food. And Ivy just took off. And then when we got home, we decided to take her on a walk and she got out of her collar and Ivy was gone in the middle of the intersection by my house. I discovered that this is a pattern with her. She is an escape artist. When Ivy first escaped from our house, we didn't know how she did it. But later we found out it was the fence that she was jumping. The evidence was blood on the fence from her jumping it. Ivy has hurt herself plenty of times from running away. When she hears any loud noise, especially power tools, she's gone. Worst fear when Ivy gets out is that she might get run over because she runs in the middle of intersections, and I don't want to pick up a dead Ivy in the street. My family's very strained from Ivy because we have to basically make our house like a prison to keep her in, and my parents want to get rid of her. But because of me, she is around, and it's not like I can move out because I'm a college student. I'm broke, so I will do anything to convince them that she needs to stay in this household. I feel like I'm her only hope, and I want to take on that challenge because she's my dog. So I don't know what Caesar can do, but I hope he can help. Because I would be devastated without her. Good girl. I get asked all the time why I love Ivy. And my answer is, I just do. I can't describe love to Ivy because how can you describe love to anybody else? It's just there. I love coming home and she's there. I love laying on my bed and she's there and cuddling with me. I feel like Ivy does love me, but when she hops that fence, it's all gone. She forgets who I am. But she is my dog. She's like my child. I love her. That's it.
So, you want to learn how to walk?
Sure.
Yeah, like, yeah. So can you see the tension there? Can you feel your tension?
Yeah.
So let's go back to where you got her. Before I do anything else, I have to show Wendy how to walk her dog because she has no idea how to do that. That's one of the most basic and important ways to establish yourself as a confident leader to your dog.
Do you want to try?
Okay.
Yeah, relax. Yeah. Okay. All right. Don't look at the dog. Just feel it through the leash. Yeah. So the more you do this, the more the dog is going to do that. The more you learn to do this, the more you slow the brain down. You see the difference?
So bring my arm up here?
Yeah. So this is more like you putting your gas pedal in the car.
Yeah.
So if you do this, the car is going to go.
Yeah.
But if you do this, this is your brakes.
Okay.
So right now what you're doing is slow down. Therefore, you use your brakes.
Okay.
So you want to be the source of calm, being calm, relaxed, peace, trust.
Okay.
See, it's foreign to you.
Yeah.
You look tense.
I just don't want her. I feel like she's going to run.
Okay, so let me change. Watch the difference. See, look at this little thing. So I'm not worried about her running away. I'm using calmness as a way of communication. Therefore, I stop her from pulling.
Mm-hmm. I never knew I was walking Ivy Ron. So that was a big eye opener. It's like, oh, I need to relax.
Teaching her how not to be afraid of sound is one thing. But teaching you guys not to worry is the most challenging thing. Because she's been escaping for 6 years, but you also guys been worrying for 6 years.
Yeah.
So both of you guys have a bad habit.
Yeah.
As Caesar and Wendy return to her home, Caesar asks her father, Craig, to turn on the air compressor.
Don't think about what's going to happen. We're setting it up.
Okay.
Where you're going to see the reaction and how I react to the situation. Mr. Craig, can you turn it on?
Yeah.
This way. Do you want to try it?
Caesar is working with Wendy and her dog Ivy, a rescue with a history of abuse that includes being shot with a BB gun. Now, Ivy runs away every time she hears a loud noise. one of her biggest triggers...
Can you turn it on?
...is Wendy's dad's air compressor.
The whole reaction is momentarily, and then it goes away. Because then they realize that they can't fight.
Okay.
It allows her to see running away is not an option. So what's my other option? Ignore.
Yeah.
Yeah. But if you go, oh my God, then you actually charge her.
Freaking out because they have the nail gun going and
a war zone. That's right. But on top of that, you feel worse than her.
Yeah.
So she doesn't feel safe.
Okay.
You worrying with her.
It's not helping.
It's not helping, yeah. You worry, she worries. You become afraid of her running away, she becomes afraid of the compressor.
Yeah. I did not realize my mood was affecting Ivy as much as it has. I thought this was just all Ivy and not me. I'm just afraid she's just gonna take off. She thrashes and she'll...
Yeah, yeah.
She knows how to get out of it.
Yeah, because that's all you've seen. So your truth is escape, escape, escape. That's like a billboard escaping.
That's been my life since we've gotten her.
6 years?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's been very stressful.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. It's amazing what fear can do to people and to their dogs. In this case, when Wendy is with Ivy, she's constantly afraid she's about to escape, and Ivy feeds off that. So I also need to see how Craig and Eleanor